What up? It's Buddy Spade. I'm gonna show you a Minecraft video with a resource pack and a shader pack. Okay, let's get right to it. I'm gonna go with my default pack first, running the shader. Show you what a normal Minecraft looks with a shader pack on it. Let's get her going. The graphics card that I'm running is the MSI Radeon 7070 series, 170 series. I've actually got a new graphics card that is on the way. It's the MSI R9 270 series, which is a new graphics card that came out last September, I believe. It's got 1280 stream processors in it. This one has 640. So basically everything on the new graphics card that I'll be getting is double what this one is. As you can see, it's awesome. I mean, everything is really detailed. You got the sun, the water. As far as shaders, you can see the grass moves and stuff. The water is moving and looks like glass now. You can see how the shadows play as you move up and down. It makes it look real. There's a lot of different things, like shader packs will move clouds, and some shader packs move the trees. Of course, these trees aren't moving. These shader packs are just for the grass and the sun and the shades. See how the shades, the shadows play? All the shadows on the different things, like the trees on the ground and all them shadows, that's from the shader pack. And that really glass-looking gloss, just awesome look. Of course, you can see I'm running around 40 frames a second with shaders and recording. Usually I ran around 125 frames a second. Bandicam drops me about 20 frames, and the shaders drop me about 40 frames. Shaders are really, really graphical. You know, the GPU has to be good. Very playable. Just awesome. I'm using my PS3 controller, so that's another thing that's helps me out a lot. Alright, you can see here when I break a tree what the tree looks like in the center and what that looks like. Now, let me show you what a resource pack is. I got the photorealism, which is the 256, which is double of these two because they're 128s, packs, and hundreds of shader packs mods. There's different shaders for everything. As you can see now, the tree looks real. The grass looks real. The grass, the dirt, each tree looks real. See that tree there? It actually looks real. It lights up when I hit it. That's the shader mod doing that. So we'll get a couple trees here. And what I'll do is I'll throw a little house together. Take me a couple minutes here. Do that real quick. Gather some wood. Make a couple tools. Go to the top of this hill over here and show you the sun. And about the time I'm done doing that, you'll be able to see the moon and everything. Different shader packs have different things. Different resource packs have different things. I think I got another resource pack on here that adds stars and the moon and a whole bunch of cool looking shit like that. I'll try that as soon as it gets dark here. I'll switch resource packs. Let's see here. Get that all leveled out. A couple more trees. I'm also going to be doing some DayZ videos. I'll be Twitching live streaming on Twitch, doing that. I got Buddy Spade set up on there already. I've already got a channel on there. I got a few streams up, but the streams aren't very good because my bandwidth is garbage until I get my fiber optic internet installed. That should be anywhere between now and the next 5 months. I went ahead and paid to get it all done, so now I'm just waiting on the install. Got that fiber optic, like Google Fiber's got 1,000 megabytes up and 1,000 megabytes down. Of course, I didn't get that because it's $100 a month for that. I got the 35 download and 19 upload on fiber optic, which is steady, will be wonderful for streaming. That's why I got this PC now. so I can stream some stuff and get some internet and stream some stuff. Basically, just do it to it, man. I got the 8-core FX8320 processor with 8 gigs of RAM. I got the Ballistic Elite RAM, this 8824 latency, so it's really good. As you can see, I got my view distances all the way up. I mean, you can see all the way across the map, pretty much. Get a good idea what it looks like, anyway. And what I'll do now is throw some of this together real quick here, like. Alright. Boom, boom, boom. I do have a quick button. I can quick stuff, you know. Just like they do on PS3. Makes it nice. Don't have to jack with it too much. Oh, better make some sticks first. Ah, you bitch. Hit the wrong button. There we go. Alright. Yeah, put that there, there, there. Alright, that and that. Of course, I need maybe one more good tree here. So I have some wood to make some coal, make some torches real quick. Of course, I do own Days. I'm sorry, 7 Days to Die. I'm gonna do some online video of that here shortly. Gonna be bringing some DayZ videos on here, some videos of The Walking Dead Survival Instinct. Gonna be doing maybe some Fallout 3 videos and some Fallout New Vegas videos. I've got a couple other games. I got the new Banished game. I may do a couple tutorial videos on that. That's an awesome looking game. Definitely. It's different. It's kind of like a little bit of Civilization Revolution with maybe some, oh, I haven't got that far in it yet. I would have to say, I don't know if there's war and stuff in it. Or, you know, I don't know if it's like Command and Conquer in that way or not. But, I will find out very shortly. Because I'm going to be doing some videos on it. Alright, what did I need here? I need a door. And there we go. Get that built up real quick. Pop that in there. All right. And here is your house. Pretty much. Let me get up here and get this real quick. Alright. Grab them, throw them in there. Grab a couple more of those. Alright, now that we got that in there, I need to get some stone before it gets dark. And I got a couple seconds to do this, so I really gotta hurry. Let me get out of here before it gets dark. I gotta hurry. The bad guys are gonna come out quick. Alright, let's get this built real quick. Pop that in there. That there. I believe it is sticks and oof, I need one tree. Shit. All right. Let me get back up here inside my little house. Of course, it's very dark. This is why you really gotta hurry and get this stuff done before it gets dark. Nope. There we go. Now we got some light and I can survive. Alright, while I'm waiting on that, I'll throw a couple more of these together. I need to make a sword. Now I can make a torch. Wonderful. Now I got some torches, I can light this bitch up. Alright. Of course my tree disappeared because I cut it down. Once you cut every piece of wood out of the tree, it eventually falls. So I'll fix that real quick here. Like, put that there. Put that to see here. Oh, shouldn't have done that. Dumbass. Alright, let's get this caught up real quick. I may actually cut that in here in a minute. Alright, now that I'm safe in here, basically all you want to do now is, you know, build you some ladders and dig down, do some mining till daylight. I always like to do a stair step mine. Of course, this shader pack that I have on makes everything really dark. You can always adjust your brightness up. Of course, I got mine all the way up. Which makes it hard, you know, when it's dark like that. So, anyway, that's it. That's all for the video today. Showed you how to get it done, get it started. Of course, you can see what the moon looks like. You can see how the the clouds move in the sky and it all looks realistic. Let me see here real quick. I can throw on this other shader pack. Thanks for watching. Definitely. And if the shader kicks me off, that's it. Let's see here. We're going to try this one here. And I think this one may be the one that adds the stars to it. Nope, no stars. Alright, let's see here. What do I got? Okay. All right. Thanks for watching, guys.